We are on the Gilstead Crags above the Wharfdale Valley, just west of Leeds. Apparently, at some point on this site or below it was a ferry well and a ferry hole, which we have yet to locate.
Let's go find it.
Okay. I'm thinking that place back there might have been the side of the well, but I don't know for sure. People used to make offerings or favors, and then later, or like healing properties, and then later, of course, they're associated with saints and stuff for the same reason. Like, you visit them on the saint's day and, you know, pray for your mother's bunions to go away or whatever, and make an offering. You usually bend pins and throw them in, or coins, or small cakes. Quite a trip up this hill. my personal theory is that this is the written form of the fairy tongue, and it represents magical contracts with the landscape. Through them.
Where do you look?
Through the hole.
I mean, what do you look at? Anything?
Well, at sites that are supposed to be enchanted. These are from the Brighton area, so I don't know if they'll work up north. I don't know if they're area specific. And then they also used to use them, cunning folk, for childbirth. They put one under each bedpost to ease childbirth too. That one would probably be the best, except it's got the tooth in the way. Thank you. This is Cleve's Cove, or Cave. It was believed to be the entrance to Elfheim. We're on the Dusk Water in Ayrshire. One of the spots associated with the cunning woman Bessie Dunlop, who had a human translated into fairy named Tom Reed, who was killed at the Battle of Pinkie 30 years before she met him, and then he served the Queen of Fairies, and she was later brought before the Archbishop of Glasgow and tried and executed at Edinburgh Assizes in 1576. And then I'm not sure who it was, but there was another later. There was a guy who said that he saw a bunch of horses riding out of this cave, although apparently they were small horses, with the fairy host, who had bows made from the ribs of unbaptized children and poisoned darts.
Maybe we can do a little intro while we're walking. Okay, yeah. This is DJ Kaleidoscope. I'm here with Lori Goldston, and we are on tour with Earth. It's April, what is it? April 18th or 19th? 2010. Do you want to tell us where we are?
We're at the Brookdale Lodge in Brookdale, California, near Santa Cruz.
It's about 12 miles north of Santa Cruz on Highway 9. And it's in the redwood forest, and it kind of looks like some really 1920s Disneyland here, and combined with like a terracotta explosion.
And we just got the deluxe ghost tour.
Yeah, which you're about to hear. But this is where the mermaids, the men, all the men would sit right here. And the women, because that's a pool, the women would wear numbers and they'd swim around in front of the window here. And the men would tell them, I want number this, I want number that. And they would get out of the pool and they'd go into, under a tunnel out into the cottages across the street, because that's the original Brookdale Lodge over there, and those cottages. Wow. And so they would meet them over there, and that was like during the early 20s and stuff like that. So long, and there's been so many deaths here.
Really?
You know, accidents, deaths. It was around during the time of prohibition, so people were killing each other over alcohol, gambling, spirits that have just been left, but not at rest. But there's nothing malicious. Sometimes you can feel a really cold spot, an entity that doesn't feel right, but there's nothing that's ever happened that was bad. If anything, there's some playful, you know. It's been said that back when the mafia used to own us, that they had buried people behind these walls, that behind these cement passages, walls. I mean, you know, you got big, huge doors here. And matter of fact, when we went up to go, I went to go show this room last night, the door opened for us. I didn't even put the key in the door. And I went back and asked the, had him call the other maid and ask if she left that door open. She said, I didn't go in that room yesterday. Well, I know when I ran out of it, I slammed the door.
Is it open again?
Yeah.
What the hell?
Is it really? It looks like it's open, yeah.
Oh my God.
I'm not sitting here. Did something just drop on my head? I don't know.
Maybe somebody stayed there for me? Oh, why is it? Uh-huh. Yeah. Okay, somebody stayed here last night.
They did? Wasn't registered to nobody.